Steve.
Okay, Schmidt. Okay.
The man, the myth, and the legend. Me and this dude, man, I was a young dude being christened into the league, man, and Steve Schmidt, man, it is definitely about the size of the fight in the dog, because that dude brought the best out of me, man. We used to go hang out at each other's houses before the game, and my mom said, hey, man, don't be hanging out with that kid, because he's out there trying to destroy you. And that was Steve's mentality, man. He wanted to go out and dominate, but just a complete receiver, man. It didn't matter where that ball was going, as you see me in his ear chirping. I had to try to give him that work. Number four, it was Larry Fitzgerald, man. We have been battling since college. Him at Pittsburgh, me at Virginia Tech. But Fitz was just the most complete receiver. He used to bring me out to Minnesota with him to work out. So I used to think so he could learn all the tricks of the trade from me and then go out and try to dominate me. But Nate, you know, Fitz probably has the best hands out of any receiver I've ever covered. No matter where you are on the field, Fitz has a chance to go up and get that football, man. Number three is Marvin Harrison, man. I don't have a lot of clips covering Marvin Harrison, but I just can remember this dude could run every route. And it also doesn't hurt to have Peyton Manning throwing you the football. But, I mean, Marvin Harrison just intimidated me so much. And he's such a little dude, man, but when he put his hands on me, I could not get off. And here you go, number two, T.O. You know, being a young dude, 21 years old, having to go out here and, you know, and cover T.O. in that first Monday night game, I really, you know, put my name on the map. But T.O. was just able to do everything, just a big physical receiver. I had Jim Moore Jr., who was with T.O., in San Francisco, who kind of told me a little bit of secrets on how to guard T.O. But that game in Philly, the dude had 7 catches in the first half. You know what he finished the game with? 7 catches. Because I tried to find a way to not get that through the ball, man, because he was the motor that kept that Philly team going. And number one, man, Nate, you talked about him earlier, man, the myth, and the legend. I came out of college running a 4.2, and this dude, as you see, ran right past me. That might have been the only incomplete I got right here. We in cover two. As you can see, we supposed to be bracketing him, but that never seemed to work out for Randy Moss. And this is the famous hand up that I spoke about at the rookie symposium, man. Coach told me when Randy put the hand up, the ball is coming. And I told Coach, I didn't know what to expect. I wasn't expecting him to be that fast. So, you know, Randy ran every route. I think a lot of people might know Randy for his speed, his deep ball speed. And you see all those Hall of Famers. Larry will be a first ballot Hall of Famer, and I'm pretty sure Steve Smith Sr. Will get in that, you know, will be getting himself a gold jacket as well. But Randy was just so special because the dude ran every single route, especially early in his career. A lot of people only see the deep balls. But Randy was a complete receiver. The same with T.O. and a lot of those guys. And look, guys, there's a lot of people that I could have put on that list that I didn't. But those are the guys that I covered that I had a hard time covering.